بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد فعن عبد الله بن محصن رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من أصبح منكم آمنا في سربه معافا في جسده عنده قوت يومه فكأنما حيزت له الدنيا بحذافيرها رواه الترمذي. Alhamdulillah, brothers and sisters, we're continuing with these life advices from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and each one of these life advices is something that can turn a person's life around. And this hadith that we're going to discuss tonight, it's actually the hadith and the whole inspiration behind these life hacks. So I was reading some of the hadith, and I came across this hadith in particular. And I said, subhanAllah, if someone would know about this, or if people knew about this and would have this perspective, how much it would change people's understanding and people's view of life. And what this is, and what this life hack is actually about, is how to attain true contentment in this life. Because most people in this world, they suffer from a sense of depression or dissatisfaction, or they're not happy with life, or, you know, and we've mentioned previously in the first hadith that, you know, look to those who are lower than you in worldly status. And don't look at those people who are higher than you in worldly status. And if you do that, then this will help you to appreciate Allah Ta'ala's favors. It will help you to honor Allah Ta'ala's favors. Otherwise, if you're looking at people above you all the time in worldly status, you will always feel like I'm missing something, or I'm a loser, I don't have, this person has better than me, this person has a better life than me. So this hadith in itself is completely change of perspective. And here the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentions that man asbaha minkum aminan fi sirbihi, that any one of you who wakes up in the morning safe in his surroundings. In other words, you have no fear that somebody's going to come inside your house, break the door, rob you, or kill you. So that's number one. Anyone who wakes up in the morning and you're safe in your surroundings. Secondly, mu'afan fi jasadihi, you are sound in your body. You don't have any physical ailments. You don't have any physical conditions. Number three, lahu qutu yawmihi, and you have your provisions for the day. You're not thinking that, oh my God, I don't think I'm going to have food today to feed my family. The one who has these three things, he's safe in his surroundings, his body is intact and healthy, and he has his daily bread. فَكَأَنَّمَا حِيزَتْ لَهُ الدُّنْيَا بِحَذَافِيرِهَا. Then this person is as if he has gathered all the blessings of this world at his doorstep. All of the blessings of the world. You are the richest human being alive, the one who has these three things. And I said, subhanAllah, how many millions of people in the world have this? But they're dissatisfied. How many millions of people in the world, they have their daily bread, more than their daily bread, they have their monthly bread. They have their bread for the entire month, and more than that. And they're safe and sound in their body. And number three, they have, you know, safety in their surroundings. Some people, you know, sometimes you could go to sleep at night with leaving the door open. It wouldn't be such a big deal. In some places, you go to sleep and you leave a window open, or you go to sleep and you leave a door open, and maybe that night you might not be safe. Maybe that night somebody might rob you. SubhanAllah. So every one of these is such a great blessing. First and foremost, if we look at the safety and surroundings, Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, the dua that he made for Makkah Mukarramah, what did he say? رَبِّ جَعَلْ هَذَا الْبَلَدَ آمِنًا. The first dua that he made for Makkah Mukarramah is what? He didn't say, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give this land deen and Islam. Give this land the true worship of Allah Azza wa Jal. Make this a Muslim land. He didn't say that first. What was the first thing that Ibrahim alayhi salam made dua? رَبِّ جَعَلْ هَذَا الْبَلَدَ آمِنًا. This is the value of Amen. Oh Allah, make this land of Makkah, make this land of the Haram, a land of safety and security. Do you know why? Because when you don't have safety and security, it doesn't matter how much you worship God. You won't be able to worship God. Look at these countries where Muslims are living. Sham, the land of, subhanAllah, the dua of the Prophet ﷺ was upon Sham. The angels spread their wings upon Sham. But because there's not safety there, thousands of people, there's an exodus of millions of refugees that are leaving the most pure and sacred lands because there's no aman. There's no safety. And those people from those lands where you can hear the adhan, the lands of the anbiya and the awliya, they're leaving that and they're coming to the lands of kufr. Because of what? Because aman is so important. And those people who have the safety in their surroundings, subhanAllah, you can worship Allah. You can pray Salatul Taraweeh. There's people, subhanAllah, I was calling family back home in Afghanistan saying, how's everything? How are you doing? They said, we're a little bit fearful of praying Taraweeh. We're a little bit fearful. This was a couple of years ago, not now. I think it's a little bit safer now. But a couple of years ago, I called and said, we are fearful. We're not going for Salatul Taraweeh. I said, what? You're not going for Salatul Taraweeh in a Muslim country? In Afghanistan, you're not going to Salatul Taraweeh? Yeah, we're not going. I said, why? He said, people are afraid. People are afraid. They're not safe. There's no safety. Can you imagine? Subhanallah. This is the value of safety. That if you don't have safety, you're not safe in your surroundings. It doesn't matter if you're living in even a Muslim country, you hear the adhan every day, there's masjid on every corner. There's pious people in masjid in every corner. It doesn't matter when you're not safe. So this safety that we have, value this. That this is one of the greatest of Allah Ta'ala's blessings. And then secondly, sound and healthy body. Somebody might say here, well, what if Allah didn't give you a sound and healthy body? What if you're in a wheelchair? What if you can't walk? Then what? Then subhanAllah, no. And glad tidings to you. And glad tidings to those who are in a predicament like that. That the Prophet ﷺ has said to them, that Allah Ta'ala, when He takes away something from His slave, when He takes away the eyes, and a person, Allah Ta'ala makes somebody by the circumstance, by the taqdeer, by the qismah, right? That was that person's naseeb. That was a person's destiny or the circumstance or the test or the examination. When Allah Azza wa Jal takes that beloved thing away from him and he has patience, Allah will give that person Jannah in place of that. What can be a greater blessing than that? SubhanAllah. That Allah Ta'ala takes away a blessing from you. Allah takes away your eyes. And you say, Ya Allah, I am pleased with what you have given and I am pleased with what you have taken away. In that, Allah Ta'ala will give you in place of what He's taken away from you. When you have patience, Allah will give you Jannah in place of that. Any blessing, remember this brothers and sisters, any blessing that Allah took away from you and you have patience upon that blessing that was taken away, whether it's health, whether it's your ability to walk, whether it's ability to talk, whether it's your ability to see, whether it's your ability to hear, and you say, Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakil, raditu billahi rabban. I make shukr. Allah is sufficient for me. Shukr in every condition. And you are grateful, then in place of that, inshallah, Allah will grant you Jannah. And that is also a blessing. And then thirdly, that you have your provisions for that day. This just in and of itself, brothers and sisters, just this in and of itself, that you know that this day today, I'm going to have something to eat. Ask those people who when they wake up in the morning, till the evening, they don't know if they have anything for their kids. They don't know if they're going to have anything for their children. How? What can go to the mind of a father or the mind of a mother or the heart of a mother and father who they cannot guarantee that they're going to feed their kids that night? What pain that is, we can never truly understand. Maybe in the month of Ramadan, we experience a little bit of that pain, a little bit of that hunger, that what people may experience, but we will never really know. So brothers and sisters, these three things, for us to be safe and sound, Alhamdulillah, we're all safe and sound. To have a healthy body, most of us have a healthy body. And number three, to have our daily bread. This is such a thing that the Prophet ﷺ said, if you have this, then you have all the blessings of the world. There's no reason why you should be depressed. There's no reason why you should be dissatisfied of life. There's no reason why you should be, you know, in a sad situation. Wallahi, just almost a month ago, a brother came up to me and said, I'm thinking about committing suicide. I said, why you want to commit suicide? Oh, you know, there's this house that I wanted and, you know, I need to make a payment for that house and I wanted to buy that house, but that house didn't work out because, you know, my wife didn't want that house, so we have to sit in a house that we have to rent it. We've been sitting in a rental for 5 years. I said, congratulations, I thought you're sitting on the street. We've been sitting in a rental for 5 years. میگم من خودکشی میکنم چرا در خانه کرایش هستیم خودکشی میکنی شکر خدا را ادا کو make shukr to Allah Ta'ala. I want to commit suicide because I'm sitting in a rental for 10 years. This is the way that people think because they don't realize what is this bounty that Allah Ta'ala has given you. Subhanallah, a roof over your head. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala has given you a shelter, a roof over your head, a place to sleep. And then people, what they make this such an issue that, oh, Subhanallah, I'm still sitting in a rental. So many years I've been sitting in a rental. What is this? Be grateful for the bounties that Allah Ta'ala has given you, because when you have these things, there's no reason why you would want to commit suicide or be depressed or, you know, become overwhelmed or dissatisfied about your life or want to commit, you know, you have problems with your wife and you want to get divorced because he hasn't provided for me properly. Provided for you properly. Here is the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam telling us that these are the three greatest blessings that we can have. We should not expect anything more than this. If we have this, then we are kings. If we have this, then we should be the most happiest person alive. May Allah Ta'ala give us the correct understanding and the proper perspective. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Subhanakallahumma hamdika nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.